Well, Ron, I think we're in for some impressive exhibition of boxing in these semi-finals. In particular, we've got a clash of the legends with Nicola Adams of Great Britain versus Mary Kom of India in the 51-kilogram flyweight category. And in the 60-kilogram lightweight category, we have Katie Taylor of Ireland in action against Mavzuna Choryeva of Tajikistan. And finally, in the 75-kilogram middleweight category, the one to look out is 17-year-old Clarissa Shields of the USA, boxing against Marina Volnova of Kazakhstan.
The referee is Veronica Schutz from Hungary.
So, plenty of boxing to come. It promises to be an exhibition of skill, but no mistake about the competitiveness that will be exhibited in that Olympic boxing ring. About for the gold medal is what awaits the victor of these semi-finals. And it promises to be as competitive as can possibly be. So we begin with the women's 48-kilogram light flyweight division. Making her way toward the boxing ring, wearing red, is the reigning, defending world championship gold medalist. Three world championship titles overall, and that is Ren Cancan of China, preparing for her third bout here in this Olympic Games competition. The number one seed, who has looked imperious during her progression this far. Her opponent, wearing blue, representing the United States of America, is Marlen Esparza from Houston in Texas. This promises to be a really explosive bout. Plenty of American fans on hand in the house, their bandanas being sported proudly. In homage to Marlen Esparza, she prepares for her second bout, having received a bye in the opening contest.
We were very impressed by Esparza in the first rounds of this competition. She threw some excellent switch of attack. She throws great eye-catching combinations. And in contrast, Ren Cancan is a master of the footwork.
And in the red corner, representing the People's Republic of China, the reigning world champion and world number one, Cancan Ren. And in the blue corner, representing the United States of America, former world championship bronze medalist, Marlen Esparza. Seconds out, round one.
The opening bell sounds to begin this women's 51-kilogram flyweight semi-final between the boxer wearing red, the number one seed in the tournament, and reigning world championship gold medalist Ren Cancan of China, boxing out of the southpaw stance, and her opponent from the United States of America, wearing blue, boxing out of the orthodox stance, is Marlen Esparza. 4 2-minute rounds will determine the outcome of this bout. And immediately we just... less than 30 seconds gone, the referee making a presence felt, reminding the two boxers that they are here to engage, they are here to compete on what is a cautious beginning to this opening round.
I don't blame Esparza for being cautious in the early part of this round. Ren Cancan is so difficult to get inside, she's so difficult to score without having encountered yourself. Ren Cancan, having equally as long a look at Esparza, she will have seen her box in the early part of this competition and will know that she's quite devastating with the combinations when she does get inside, so she will want to keep it long, keep it at range.
These two boxers will be very familiar with one another, as Esparza got through with a good right hand to the body. They met at the semi-final stage. The quarter-final stage of the World Championships in China just a few months ago. It was Ren who prevailed on that occasion en route to the gold medal. And how significant will that World Championship encounter be here on the Olympic stage?
Well, it gives her a huge set of confidence going into this bout. They know a lot about each other. They will have gone away and worked with their teams, with their coaching teams, to find a strategy around each other's defences and to combat each other's attacks.
16-8 to Ren on that particular occasion. She got through with a good right left to the body just before the closing bell. And at the end of the first round, perhaps that final flurry was enough just to tip the balance in Ren's favour. She leads by a scoreline of 3-2 after the first round in his women's semi-final.
I think that's a fair reflection. We saw Cancan here just landing her a couple of straight shots there, but again countered by Esparza. We see the very jumpy footwork of Esparza here, in contrast to Ren's rather relaxed stepping footwork. Esparza attacking there with her combinations. Did well to avoid that counter from Cancan.
Right there, 3-2, down one, all right? All that needs would be 1 point to tie, 2 to win. Let's go. Maintain.
Round two.
As we move into the second round of this women's 51-kilogram flyweight semi-final, it is a boxer wearing red operating out of the southpaw stance, Ren Cancan of China, who has a one-point advantage after the first round of boxing. She leads the United States of America's Marlen Esparza by a scoreline of 3-2 after what was a fairly cautious start to the opening round by both boxers. This a rematch from the quarterfinal stage. As Esparza just warned for punching incorrectly with the inside part of the glove rather than the knuckle part of the glove. But it was during that World Championships in China that Esparza became the first American boxer to qualify for this tournament on behalf of the USA, one of the four teams present here at London 2012 with a full complement of boxers. As the two boxers do now engage at short range. It was a left hook that ended the exchange from Esparza.
I think we have to give credit to Ren here. She does make it so incredibly difficult for anyone to get near her.
Second time that the referees had to intervene. She did so within the first 30 seconds of this semi-final, reminding the two boxers that they are here to engage and provide a competitive spectacle of boxing for the fans in attendance. That brings about a flurry of attack from both boxers, but again, there's plenty of feinting, plenty of boxing at range, but invariably both boxers falling short and out of range with their punches.
I think it's a little bit harsh by the ref. They are working, they're feinting, they're using their feet. This is boxing, and this is clever boxing, and it's the right tactics to employ by the both of them. Believe me, there's no lack of energy, no lack of effort going on in this bout, regardless of the fairly low punch rate.
Ren just moving backwards to avoid that onrush of attack from Esparza. And then boxing neatly on the ropes. Esparza trying to work away while she's got Ren hit her back to the ropes. But Ren using good footwork to move away from that place of confinement and get back too close to center Ren. And at the end of the round, Ren has increased her advantage to 3. It was 3-2 in her favor at the end of the first. At the end of two completed rounds, she leads by a scoreline of 7-4.
Yeah, Ren just picking the single eye-catching shots there. Boxing and moving as Esparza comes in. Esparza, you can see there, gets a nice little rear uppercut onto the chin of Ren. Cuffing right hand there by Ren, finishing off that sequence. A double right hook there, just moving off at the angle, not allowing Esparza to get anywhere nearer. Esparza chose the right times to throw her combinations when Ren was on the ropes. But there remains a point deficit.
Round three.
So as we move into the third of a scheduled 4 2-minute rounds in its women's 51-kilogram flyweight semi-final, the boxer wearing red, the reigning world championship gold medalist, the three-time world champion overall, Ren Cancan of China, is leading the bronze medalist from 2006 World Championships, Marlen Esparza, by a scoreline of 7-4 after two completed rounds of boxing. And the pattern we're seeing here in the opening 30 seconds of round number three is one that has been evident throughout the contest so far. Plenty of studying, plenty of examining, plenty of feinting. Just trying to work to secure an opening as Esparza continues to fall short on her forays forward.
Esparza can't afford to dive in there from the centre of the ring. Ren's too clever for that. She needs to push Ren back to the ropes with her feet, with that feinting that she's doing. She needs to just edge the feet forward, close the gap down. Easier said than done against Cancan Ren. She's not 3-time world champion for nothing. She's incredibly accomplished on the back foot.
Esparza from Houston in Texas, and of course, Olympic athletes and aspiring Olympians fund their training in all kinds of ways as Ren gets through with a good long lead right hand. But being from Houston, Texas, Esparza received some assistance from another notable Houston Olympian, the legendary Big George Foreman, Olympic champion in Mexico 1968 as a teenager, won, of course, to become 2-time heavyweight champion of the world in the professional ranks as Ren gets through with another good right hand. And he provided a check through the mail to Ren, excuse me, to Esparza and her team, and she is duly produced by becoming an Olympian representing the United States of America. She's facing a deficit coming into this third round. She doesn't appear to have done enough to have overturned that deficit, and with the effective singles that Ren has been landing, Ren may as well have increased what was a 3-point advantage at the end of round two. In fact, it's Esparza who has closed the gap to 2 points, but she still trails by a scoreline of 8-6.
I'm not sure I saw that, Ron. I thought that Ren here employed that double right hook effectively, and also the backhand right hook, check hook, I think landed on two or three occasions during that round. Esparza did catch her there with a left hook as Ren moved away. But Esparza, I thought, just launched her attacks from the middle of the ring and allowed Ren to counter and move off.
Just down two. Come on, we can get
down two.
Two. Down two. 8-6. Listen, you're right there. Okay. Come on.
Gotta go out and get it.
Close that gap. We're too far. We're too much. All right.
As we move into the fourth and final round of this women's 51 kilogram flyweight fourth quarter semi-final, the boxer wearing blue, Marlen Esparza, received an encouragement of inspirational talk from her corner and tactical advice, but it was mainly encouragement as she trails by just 2, 8-6 coming into this fourth and final round. She scores with a good left hand out of that orthodox stance, but Ren has led at the end of each of the completed 3 rounds as Esparza has just struggled to get inside the reach advantage that Ren possesses.
Esparza's coach there in the corner, just a little bit of tactical advice, saying you've got to close the gap down. You're launching from too far away. You're easy to read. But when she catches Ren there with a lovely rear hand to the body. And again with a rear uppercut left hook. Beautiful.
So just passing the halfway stage and in this fourth and final round. Remember, the winner will progress to the gold medal bout in the 51 kilogram flyweight division. Ren is the number one seed, the reigning world championship gold medalist, the 2010 Asian Games gold medalist as well. She's taking on the 2-time Pan Am champion from 2008 and 2012, Marlen Esparza, 5-time national champion as well, world championship bronze medalist from the 4 she's competed in. She got that bronze in 2006, but inside these final 30 seconds, she's going to have to do something in a bid to overturn what was a 2-point deficit. She launches a left-right combination near the right, landed on the bicep, but that was a cracking left hook out of the orthodox stance from Esparza.
Esparza's possibly clawing some shots back here, but she needs to go twice. She needs to go because Ren Cancan goes back in a straight line, but then she needs to go again with a second phase and catch her as she's on the rope. She's just doing a one-phase attack at the moment. If she could only go twice, she'll score the point.
Well, at the end of the round, contest in which Esparza trailed by 2 going into that final 2-minute round, she launched a furious attack. There was plenty of aggression, but was it effective enough to overturn a 2-point deficit? She trailed by a scoreline of 8-6 against the number one seed and reigning world championship gold medalist Ren Cancan.
We just saw a clear right hand being landed by Esparza, and there again, lovely right uppercut to the body and a left hook. Getting out of the way of that counter punch from Ren.
So the winner will progress through to the gold medal bout. Person who comes out on the wrong end of the points verdict from their point of view will leave with some Olympic hardware. The losing semi-finalists in Olympic boxing are guaranteed a bronze medal. But that won't be on their mind at this particular point in time. Victory is uppermost in the minds of both of these boxers who will progress through to the gold medal bout.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by score of 10 points to 8 in the red corner, representing the People's Republic of China, Cancan Ren.
So Ren Cancan, the tournament number one seed and reigning world championship gold medalist, will contest the first ever women's boxing gold medal bout in the 51 kilogram flyweight division after she controlled proceedings very well indeed to prevail by a scoreline of 10 points to 8 over America's Marlen Esparza.